Hello, welcome back to Physio4U, the physiotherapy channel. Today, we'll talk about plagiocephaly, so if this sounds interesting to you, please keep watching. For those who are new in this channel, I am Ekaterini Zyaka and I have been a physical therapist for almost 30 years now, and I work with children and adults with neurological or neurokinetic disorders. I have a master's degree in prism adaptation therapy, and I am an NDT, OMT, VMT and CST therapist. What to expect when my child has plagiocephaly? This is the most common question that parents have asked me when their baby struggles with plagiocephaly. Prevention methods include caring the infant and giving the infant time to be on his tummy, which prevents plagiocephaly from progressing from mild to moderate or severe. Early intervention is important to prevent and reduce the severity or the degree of the plagiocephaly. Preliminary research indicates that developmental delays or difficulties like motor and language developmental delays can occur in some babies with plagiocephaly or any other deformity, but to tell you the truth, it's not always clear that this is the cause of the delay. Plagiocephaly often doesn't need treatment, but it seems like it can auto-heal as your baby grows. Normally, this happens because infant's head shape will naturally improve as the skull changes shape during growth and the baby spends more time at his tummy instead of his back, and the gross motor function allows the baby to spend more time in positions other than supine. However, we don't know at first exactly how the child's developmental procedure will be, and secondly, if he will adapt to his age milestones. So, the simple recommendations about plagiocephaly could help the infant's developmental procedure, and it might prevent serious effects. It is always preferred to visit a specialized pediatric physiotherapist or a pediatrician instead of waiting and seeing how is your baby's growth. But in case that you haven't seen already a therapist, there are some indications that might help you with your baby's developmental gross motor function. How can we treat plagiocephaly? The course of treatment is usually based on the age of the child, the severity of the condition, and the type of plagiocephaly, if it's mild, severe, or moderate. Diagnosis is most commonly determined through clinical examination by the pediatrician or the specialized pediatric physiotherapist. In order to assess the severity of the condition and determine the best course of treatment, practitioners often use the plagiocephaly severity scale, which is a standardized scale evaluation. Treatment usually includes the reduction of the pressure of the affected area. This might happen if reposition the baby in their abdomen or repositioning the head for extended periods of time throughout the day. Repositioning cribs or other areas that the baby spends time in, repositioning furniture and other toys for similar reasons. Don't use car seats except when the baby is actually in the vehicle, and don't use bouncy seats or any other supine seating products. Crawling may also be crucial in preventing plagiocephaly, as it strengthens your baby's spine and neck muscles and also boosts gross and fine motor skills balance, hand-eye coordination, and overall strength. During the day, give your baby the opportunity to play on his side in order to develop the eye-hand coordination. In the cot or on the change table, alternate the end that your baby is placed on. Talk to him or her, place a toy, shake a rattle from his or her less favorite side, so to encourage the turning more his head to that side. The recommendations about face-up sleeping time to reduce the risk of sudden infant death syndrome mustn't upset you. Instead, you can spend a lot of tummy time with your baby during the day. Simple and gentle stretching exercises, it might improve the baby's neck mobility, and there are some recommendations about how you must carry and handle your baby, and that depends on the type and the severity of plagiocephaly. The positions variety is the key for motor and cognitive development. So during feeding time, the baby must be placed on his side either way. It must be said that there isn't any recommendation in any case to take your baby to a chiropractor for back or neck adjustments. When does plagiocephaly go away? Plagiocephaly usually is noticed between the ages of 6 weeks and 2 months old. This might be resolved completely by the age of 2 years old, and it depends by the severity, the age of the baby, and the type of plagiocephaly. Usually, the baby's growth is normal in most cases. Plagiocephaly can be disconcerting, especially for new parents, but it rarely causes any harm. As parents, you must leave the babyhood even if there is some signs of plagiocephaly, because this age will be gone before you know it. When treatment starts at the optimum age of 3 to 6 months, it can usually be completed within 12 weeks. Correction is still possible if your baby is up to age 18 months. The decision to give the baby plagiocephaly treatment or to use a helmet is not yours, but the pediatricians or the pediatric physiotherapists to make. Otherwise, it can only cause huge anxiety and stress of what might happen in your baby's developmental process.